Christ.
What's up, guys? Today I wanted to actually show off my Moon Patrol that I put together. I know it's been a while since I've posted a video, and a lot of it was spent working on this, and I had a lot of video footage of the restoration that unfortunately the memory card of my camera got corrupted. So I was only left with footage of me dropping my camera, and there's a little bit of footage of me putting on the stencil on the side, which isn't that exciting, so I figured I'd scrap it and we'll just do a walk around the cab and show you all the work that I put into this. And you saw me work on a little bit of the Mortal Kombat 2, so I've been busy. I need to be more proactive with these video uploads. Some games have come and gone in the arcade. Whole bunch of work in the Nintendo cab. That's this I'm actually filming too, so we should have some more videos coming up soon, and I'm hoping to get them cranked out a little bit faster. But anyway, so let's get back to Moon Patrol. So this is a dedicated Moon Patrol cabinet that I got from a buddy of mine. It was actually painted black. It had, Bad Dudes it was converted to. It was awful. He ended up stripping all the internals, like the power supply and the PCB, and I think he ended up selling them on eBay. And he wanted to get rid of the cabinet. So I took the cabinet off his hands. It came with the control panel. The overlay was different. He did have the bezel and the cabinet were the only parts. I had to get a reproduction marquee that I got from Joe Zabo, I believe I'm pronouncing his name right, hopefully. Zabo's Arcade. He's actually got a website out now where you can buy reproduction artwork. And if he doesn't have it on his website, he'll create one for you. And then I got the reproduction CPO, control panel overlay, that I got from Game On Graphics. This is just a cheap, zippy reproduction joystick. Leaf switch is in here, so it feels just like the original, other than this clicky thing. It is, something I should point out, it is a two-way joystick. It doesn't go up or down, it's just left and right, because when you're driving your Moon Patrol tank, you can only go slow or faster. You're always going right, so there's no up or down, but you do have a jump and a fire. Reproduction control panel overlay, original bezel, reproduction marquee. I got this little thing. It's just a metal sticker, really, metallic sticker that I got off eBay for like 15 bucks. I actually have one on the Joust cabinet. It isn't metal, it's just a sticker. It's just something cool, I thought. I mean, it's better than having nothing here. But this font is actually different than this font. Now that I notice the Williams logo's on the right and this one's on the left. Not a big deal. It's just whatever. It's just aesthetics. And then I ended up stenciling the side. You know, let me see if I can get. Yeah, I'm not gonna try to move Mortal Kombat. Let's you know what? Let's pull out Moon Patrol, and we'll look at the side art and open up the back door and talk about what I did on the inside. Let me get my flashlight because you're not gonna be able to see anything. There we go. Perfect. All right, so we got the back door off. And this tube actually came. Where did this tube come from? It came out of another game I had, and I can't remember which one I stole it from. But it is a Wells Gardner, and I can't find the sticker that tells us what the chassis is. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Who cares? This is what I really want to show you. This wired mess. No, just kidding. This wired mess. Actually, this thing right here is my first attempt at making a JAMA harness.
based on the pinout for Moon Patrol, which I'm going to post right now. There's actually a couple graphics online to show you where to put your what pin goes to which pin on the JAMA to IREM. Yes, IREM. But all you do is you just move, you look at what you need it to be, and then just essentially just trace a line and put a wire to it. It's not hard. It's tedious as all hell. I would not recommend doing it. Other than saving money, like I think you can actually buy one for I think $40. Mike's Arcade got one. You'll see him pop up on eBay every once in a while. The parts alone I think only cost like maybe $8. So I did save money, but it took me like 2 days off and on just to put this thing together. I'd have a little bit of time, put a few wires on, then I'd run out of time and have to do something, adult responsibilities. And then I'll pick it back up another day. So anyway, from now on, I'm not building these things. I'm just buying them. I'd rather spend $40 than build this thing. But some of you guys out there actually might do better than I did on this thing. I suck at soldering, as you can see. I got some big solder joints. Anyway, so that's it. It's an IREM to JAMA harness adapter. And then I just wired it up for JAMA. There's the switching power supply. And here's my zip-tied mess. Everything's going where it should go. And yeah, and now we have a game. So, yeah, that's it on the inside. So, I mean, this is actually leftover from when it was a Williams game, I believe. That is a, oh, you know what, that power supply is actually still hooked up. I don't know what it's powering. What are you powering? Now I'm curious. Isolation transformer, which looks like it is powering. Oh, you know what? All it's powering. I literally just now traced the wires back. It's powering those two light bulbs on the coin door. So, whatever. I'm leaving it. So, all right. So let me wheel this thing out, and I'll show you the stencil work that I did. All right, guys. Here's the stencil job that I did. I picked up stencils from GameStencils.com, which is a very suiting website domain name for game stencils. It's the same people I went to for the Joust stencils, and although I don't have footage of me putting this stencil on, if you look at my Joust restoration video, it shows how I did, how I put the stencil on, how I painted it, all that stuff. It's the exact same process for this. Everything's the same. So when I got the cab, it was all painted black. I stripped the black with citrus strip and actually revealed the Moon Patrol artwork underneath of it. This isn't it, this is the re-stencil. But I have a picture of it right here. Had some black crud still left over. And then the citrus strip started eating into the original artwork. So that's actually the determination when I decided to re-stencil this thing. So I got some cheap blue paint from Walmart. I didn't try to color match. I just picked closest to what I thought looked close to the original. This yellow is a little more paler, I guess, if that's even a word. The blue is actually really close. I want to say the yellow on the original one is a lot more brighter, almost like a mustard yellow. But I thought this looked kind of like a 50s, 60s space theme Moon Patrol, kind of like a Fallout, like that kind of style. Anyway, so it was only two colors, just the dark blue and yellow. And let's see, I don't know if I want to show you. There's some spots where I messed up. I had to do some touch-ups. And this side, I think, was pretty good. I got some bleed through on the stencil. That's not a big deal. Oh, here you go. Here's a spot that came up that I had to color match the blue, and you can see that it's not perfect. But from afar, it's pretty much hell. And then the other side, can I get to the other side? Let's do a whole lap around the arcade. Same thing. It's a mirror image. I mean, as far as whatever, you get what I'm saying. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Word of advice when you do put stencils on, put the stencil on, paint it,
the whatever their first color is, don't touch it for 24 hours after you put that paint on. Give it time to cure and set into the paint behind it, or the primer or whatever you got behind it. That's actually why I had some came up. I forgot that tidbit of information from the first time I did the Joust. Remember, I had to do some touch-ups for that. So yeah, put your first color on, paint it, let it sit for 24 hours, even more maybe. The longer you let it sit, the easier it's gonna be to pull the stencil template off. And then go ahead and put your other stencil on and spray that on. So that's that. Yeah, I think it turned out pretty nice. It's one of my favorite looking caps. I don't know, that artwork's really cool to me for some reason. I think because of that style. Anyway, let's put this guy back in place, fire it up, and play a little Moon Patrol.
Alright, got the tripod set up. Let's play a little bit of Moon Patrol. Coin it up. And so this game was developed in 1982 by a company called IREM, and then they licensed it to Williams. And one of the reasons I was eager to put this project together is there's actually a multi-Williams board out there that runs the original code. It's not emulated, it's legit, all the old Williams games, but it doesn't have Moon Patrol in there, I think because it's different hardware. But anyway, so long story short, you can't get this on your multi-Williams. You can get so I think some of the multi-boards, like the emulated like Chinese boards have this, but it doesn't really compare to the real deal. So anyway, IREM, 1982, licensed by Williams, and it's actually known for being the first game to introduce parallax graphics, which I will show you right now. And parallax is, it essentially just means your foreground moves slower than your, or I'm sorry, moves faster than your background. And it gives you that sense of depth. You have to jump over these craters. You have a fire button that shoots up and straight at the same time. And you got alien a-holes dropping bombs on you. And the whole point of the game is just to get from point A to point B. So you're just trying to get to the end of the level. And there's waypoints, like right now we just hit B. Waypoints, checkpoints, so if I die, I believe I start back at B. And I die. And as you go, it progressively gets a little bit harder. Like there's more spaceships that drop bombs that actually creates craters. So not only do you have to jump the ones that are already on the map, they're creating new ones dynamically right in front of you. And if you, wasn't paying attention. If you hold right on the joystick, you actually go faster. If you pull back, your guy slows down a bit. So that comes in handy when your craters are like super close together, you gotta time it a little bit. And another trick, if you wanna get a little bit more, actually those are the guys that make the craters when they drop bombs. If you jump and shoot, it actually narrows the window of when the spaceships can actually fly past you, so it actually makes it a little bit, makes it a little bit easier. Easier said than done when I'm actually talking about it. Pull back a little bit, because I'm gonna crash. And then you get to the end of the level. I doubt I got a high score. Oh yeah, I did. Oh, no bonus. Boo. And you can get high score save kits. Maybe one day I'll get one. Yeah, you see how that background moves a little bit different pace than the foreground? That's all that parallax is. And I got freaking game over. You know, I got another crit. Let's play one more game. This time I'm not going to talk. Let's see if I do better if I'm actually paying attention. We'll be right back. Let's see if I got a bonus that time. Boo! Screw it. Let's keep going until I get game over. Whoa, what are these? Ah! I don't remember these. It shows you how often I get to actually play these games when I don't even remember. I guess they're mines? Damn! Alright. So you see it progressively gets more difficult. I suck. But don't blame my skill. It's just because I don't have time to practice these things. I barely have time to work on these games. And then playing them is a luxury. I have all these games, I don't even get to play them that often. So that's kind of a bummer. But Moon Patrol is done. One more project I can scratch off the list of projects I got. Oh, what do we have left? Well, Mortal Kombat's another project we can scratch off. This actually works. It worked when I picked up. It was just missing some artwork, which is no big deal. A buddy of mine actually printed this off at his work. So that was cool. Appreciate that. Should we talk? Yeah, let's talk about the other projects. Operation Wolf, we're now missing a coin door. I stole that because I sold another game that I needed. Operation Thunderbolt is a new game. Revolution X, new game I haven't showed you guys, but it's 50-50. I'll turn it on and it works, and some other times it doesn't work. You saw Ms. Pac-Man, Bosconian. Ninja Turtles, you can't see because there's no light. This is a new game, Gauntlet Legends. We'll talk about that later. Fixit Felix, you know about. Space Invaders, you know about. Mega Attack, nothing new. Also, Mortal Kombat 3 is fine, nothing new with that. Oh, yeah, this is a new guy. Currently in pieces, doesn't work. I have everything, it just does not. It's not playable, it's not in a playable state. Quartet works, except this guy's button comes and goes. I think that needs to be repinned, nothing crazy. This is new-ish. It's been here for a while, but I don't think you guys have seen it. Atari hard driving. It worked, kinda, and I didn't like it, so I tried to sell it. Nobody wants to buy this giant big thing, so I ended up parting it out. So right now, it's just an empty cabinet. I sold the boards out of it. I have the monitor still, which is a medium res monitor, which would have came in handy when I had Virtual Cop because it ran off medium res, but it didn't have it when I had this. So, I don't know what I'm doing with this. It might be, I'm debating either to just get rid of the whole thing or make it a MAME racer. I don't know. Over there in the corner, we got the Neo Geo. The monitor's dead. I actually don't have a game for it. I think I'm gonna trade that to a buddy of mine. And then we got Nintendo Row, which I'm doing a whole bunch of work on and filming everything. Also eating up my time. So, that's all the projects. That's Moon Patrol. Next to Joust, it looks pretty awesome. We have a mini Williams Rail. I'd like to get a Sinistar, I think that'd be cool. So yeah, back to that multi-Williams board, I think that it would be a cool, if I had another Williams cannon, to throw the multi-board in there so we have Joust, Moon Patrol, and then we could have every other Williams game, like, Bubbles, that'd be a cool one. Sinistar, Blaster. Why am I drawing like Robotron? Why did I forget Robotron? Anyway, so that's it. I just wanted to show you what I've been working on, all the projects. I'm keeping busy. I haven't forgotten about you guys. I appreciate you guys tuning in, checking out my videos. If you haven't subscribed, I would greatly appreciate it if you did.
If you're an arcade enthusiast or have any questions, feel free to shoot me a message. I can try to help out as much as I can. And then I'll see you guys next time.